Hey everybody, I'm Doug Meyer. Welcome to 4x4 TV. Once again, we're coming to you from the Paiute ATV trail country in central Utah. Yeah, now if you remember, last week we were up on the Monroe Mountain. You can see that over my shoulder. Now that was last week for you, yesterday for us. We spent a lot of time exploring that, and there's one thing about these trails here in Utah is that there is a bunch of them. So that even when you get to another trail, you look back and go, wait a minute, now I could have come down that other side of that mountain. I could have done this. I guarantee you that when you get here, you're never going to explore enough of these trails. You know, this is, I've told this to the ATV people over and over again, that this is a trail system that you should aspire to come to once. You know, plan your vacation, plan a week, plan 4 days and come here. And I'd be willing to guarantee you that once you make one trip here, you're going to leave wanting more. You're going to want to come back and do this again, explore more trails. And after a few times, you get a better idea of where you want to go, what you want to see, pick some different trails. We've shown you some harder ones because of weather. We've shown you some more scenic ones just because of the countryside. Now today, we've taken off from I-70 from a small town of Joseph, kind of between Richfield, where the ATV Jamboree is, and where we would end up from the Monroe Peak or Monroe Mountain trails, and I-70, where the Fremont Indian Reservation is, where we took off. Fremont State Indian Park is where we took off and went up Mill Creek. So now we've taken off of Joseph, and we're about 4 miles up just an easy road to get up into the Fish Lake National Forest and the Pavant Range. Now the Pavant Range appears to be a little bit drier, but it's a plateau up here, still high. We've already climbed up to over 8,000 feet, and we're going to get up to over 9 up here. Pavant is a pretty flat range where you can get up and you've got just fantastic views of the area like you see behind me. So this is another one of those that roughly follows some of the ATV trails, but again, if you stay on the roads, there's no problem, and there are plenty of roads to follow. So we're going to head on up here because we're going to get up into this higher country, hopefully get some just fantastic views of the surrounding area, and we can look at some of the other mountain ranges compared to our map and see where else we'd like to go. So come on along, let's explore the Pavant Range. Here's the thing with this whole area that we call Paiute Trail Country. It's huge. I mean, really huge. Thousands of miles of trails. So while we're going to spend a day up here, you could realistically spend a week up here just trying to explore all of these trails. Now, hopefully by now you've already called or emailed and got your own map of this area. Or even this map and the maps of all the surrounding areas as well. That way you can see just how big this area really is. You could head up out of the town of Salina, which is about 35 miles east on I-70 from where we headed up. Or there's a couple of trails up into the Pavants from Fillmore, which is about 30 miles further north on I-15 from where we took I-70 inward. You know, that's a great thing about this area, and one of the reasons it's so popular with the ATVers. There are small towns scattered all around the edges of the mountains that provide the basic services to keep you going. In fact, I bet if you had the time and the money, you could probably start out at one end of these trails and spend the entire summer exploring and camping and never get all the trails in this area completed. Oh yeah, here's something you need to always be aware of in most of the Paiute Trail Country, and especially up here in the Pavants. Cattle. This is prime grazing land for a lot of ranchers, so please be careful around the livestock and respectful of their right to be here. In fact, it's because so much of this land is used for grazing that there's so many roads open in this area. So please drive by slowly and don't wave your bag of jerky out the window at them. You know, it's best to let them think that they're here as scenic enhancers, because you know what they say about happy cows. Oh, and remember those cows when you camp too. Don't drink the water.